Hello, I am Dr. Vijay Patil, Professor of Community Medicine. Today's topic is occupational hazards and diseases. With growing complexity of various industrial processes, the nature of hazards is also becoming complex. So let us see our first slide. It is important to know what is occupational health first. The aim of occupational health is promotion and maintenance of highest degree of physical, mental and social well-being of workers in all occupations. The prevention of ill health among workers caused by their working conditions. The protection of workers in their employment from risks resulting from factors that adversely affect health. The placing and maintenance of the worker in an occupational environment adapted to his psychological and physiological ability. Why we need to study occupational hazards? For students, it is important to make wise career decisions and create awareness about dangers, diseases, risks in various occupations. Occupational hazards or diseases are classified as: number 1, physical hazards; number 2, chemical hazards; number 3, biological hazards; number 4, mechanical hazards; and number 5, psychosocial hazards. Physical hazards, most important and common, is hazards due to heat. Most of the industries, they use boilers or chemical reactions generate heat. To begin with, heat exhaustion, where there is heavy sweating, weakness or fainting, cold, pale and clammy skin, rapid weak pulse, nausea or vomiting, and muscle cramps. More exposure leads to heat stroke, where a person may lose his consciousness. Further exposure can lead to heat syncope. The symptoms of heat syncope are lightheadedness, dizziness, fainting because of pulling of blood in legs causing drop in blood pressure, lack of acclimatization and loss of body fluid from sweating. Heat cramps are commonly experienced by a sports person when they have to do workout in hot and humid climates. Prickly heat is very common skin condition where exposure to heat is more. Direct exposure to fire, which leads to burn. Burns are classified into 3 degrees. First degree burns, where only epidermis is involved. Second degree burns, where epidermis and dermis are involved. And third degree or deep burns, where subcutaneous tissue, vessels or muscles are involved. Occupations which are prone to heat illnesses are agricultural workers, nursery workers, dairy workers, firefighters, carpenters, civil engineers, factory workers, street sweepers, athletes, bakers, cooks, soldiers, industrial engineers, electricians, electrical engineers, traffic policemen, truck drivers, etc. The second thing is excessive exposure to cold. The chilblains is the condition where painful lump occur as a response to excessive cold. Second condition is frostbite or trench foot or immersion foot, where skin is damaged due to damp and cold. This slide shows difference of skin color. Skin has become very much pale and the circulation of blood is very much less. Who usually get cold stress? The workers in places that have winter, fishermen, people working in the grocery, minding the frozen food, road construction workers, fish markets, vendors, miners, cold storage workers, soldiers, etc. Third is light. Light, when it is excess, it is harmful. When it is very less, again it is harmful. The occupational hazards are occupational cataract, usually people working in radiation and X-ray departments. And second condition is miner's nystagmus, an occupational disease that occurs among coal miners, usually those of middle age or elderly. Its physical symptom consists of difficulty of seeing in the dark or in poor light, and there is oscillatory movement of cornea. Caisson's disease or decompression sickness, where in deep sea divers under pressure the aerial gas embolism can occur. So this is serious occupational hazard. Another hazard in industry is noise exposure. Excessive exposure to noise, the workers, they can cope up to 80 decibels. If the above 80 decibel exposure is there, they have to use protective devices like ear muffs. When it is more than 105 decibels, the devices used for protection are more sophisticated and more controlling the noise. Sudden exposure to 140 decibels may cause hearing loss. The flights or rock concerts, sand blasting, the decibel level is 120. It can cause temporary hearing loss. Noise exposure leads to noise induced hearing loss. And then who are at risk? Farmers, civil engineers, road construction workers, factory workers, miners, mining engineers, musicians, airline workers, police, soldiers, and pilots. Next hazard is radiation. Common sources of radiation are telephone, navigation equipment, radio, television, then Wi-Fi equipment, microwaves, infrared radiation waves from cooking and heat, then visible light, ultraviolet lights. More serious things are radiation due to X-ray during medical scanning and gamma rays. So these are the common sources of radiation. Biological effects of ionizing radiation are somatic, somatostochastic, and genetic. In somatic effects, there is acute radiation sickness, skin and tissue burns, chronic radiation sickness, alopecia, X-ray cataract, clinical register frustration of hemopoiesis, temporary or constant sterility. Prolonged radiation gives rise to carcinogenic effects and teratogenic effects. More dose of radiation for prolonged period gives to genetic mutations and chromosomal aberrations leading to chromosomal abnormalities. Now we come to mechanical factors. Mechanical factors, these are all moving, protruding, sharp machinery parts and other mechanical injuries because of slippery surfaces, fall, not good housekeeping. It can cause impact, crush injuries or sucking in, shearing, severing, winding, entanglement, stabbing, puncture wounds, punching, projections, and impact crushing and falling objects or causing injuries. Another mechanical injury is because of vibration. Vibration frequency range of 10 to 500 hertz tools such as drills and hammers, they lead to repeated stress trauma to hands and arms. After some months or years of exposure, the fine bed vessels of fingers may become increasingly sensitive to spasm, leading to white fingers. Exposure to vibration may also produce injuries of joints of hands and shoulders. Now, another important group is chemical hazards. The effects of chemical hazards are organ specific. The chemical have got affinity of particular organs. Say, renal diseases are caused by like acute and chronic renal failure, or caused by chemical compounds like mercury, cadmium chloroform, which is used in battery industry, other chemical industries, pesticide industries. Respiratory diseases are more seen due to like irritation, inflammation, pneumoconiosis. The chemical agents responsible are all solvents, ammonia, inorganic dust and organic dust. Industries where they are used are chemical industries, mining, construction, sand blasting, coal, etc. Cancers are common because of chromium in industry which is used plating, metal refining. Cancer of liver, that is nowadays becoming common because of polyvinyl chloride excessive use of polyvinyl chloride. So these the chemical reactions in many industries are complex, and so the complexity of its hazards are growing day by day. The chemical agents are in different forms. There are gases which contains chemicals can lead to gas poisoning. There are inorganic dust like coal dust, silica dust, asbestos dust, iron dust, which causes pneumoconiosis like anthracnose, silicosis, asbestosis, siderosis. There are organic dust like cane fiber giving rise to pneumoconiosis like bagasosis. Cotton dust gives rise to bacinosis. Hay or grain dust give rise to farmer's lung. There are chemicals which directly cause burns, dermatitis, cancer, respiratory illnesses. Chemicals in the form of metals like lead, mercury, arsenic, chromium, which cause poisoning. Next group is biological hazards. That covers all biological agents like viruses, fungi, parasites, bacteria. So they lead to all sorts of infections, infestations caused due to their working conditions. For example, it's wool sorters disease or leptospirosis or anthrax. Another important group is psychosocial hazards. Psychosocial hazards, that is work related stress, excessive working time, overwork, burnout, bullying at the place of work which gives to emotional trauma or verbal abuse, sexual harassment for employees, violence at work, body odors which can cause nuisance. The health effects are occupational stress, anxiety, depression, cardiovascular disorders, GI disorders, drug abuse and smoking. To avoid all these psychosocial hazards, person should slow down, keep calm, be positive, take it easy, unplug, enjoy life, have fun, breathe, relax, go outside, smile, and most important, meditate. Thank you.